Good evening. Welcome to the Four School Choral Festival and welcome to Sanford School. My name is Mark Anderson. I am the head here, and we're just so pleased to host the events that happened today and to have you all here tonight for the program. This is my 13th year here at Sanford and 13th year in Wilmington, and I have so come to appreciate not only this night, but the collegiality that we share among our four schools. It's not every mid-sized city that has four preschool through grade 12 schools that compete in many ways. Athletically, we compete in the enrollment arena. But I love this event because we are not competing tonight. We're here to perform together, to learn together, and to celebrate the talents of our students. And really, that's what it's all about. I want to thank all of the professionals who came in town tonight, today, who worked with our students throughout the day at the festival, and also to all of our choir directors who worked hard to pull the event together. Can you join me in giving that group a big round of applause? On behalf of all of us here at Sanford, we wish you a happy new year, and we hope you enjoy the program. Thank you so much.
Thank you. supposed to say anything, but we had an awesome day, and so I want to say thank you to Mr. Williams and the administration of Sanford for hosting this incredible event. It was a blast to be part of it, and we're really honored to sing for you tonight. So I hope you enjoy two songs from the Tatnall choir. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. students, and we are so lucky to have him here. He was here in Delaware doing our All-State Chorus probably 2012. And, but I remember what we did, but it's been 2 or 3 years ago. So, Mrs. Butterfield, you were 22 or 23 at that time, probably.
17.
So, we've had a great time with him today, and our collaborative pianists with us are Lori Gengel and Raylan Newler. And if you're fans of their work, come to Cape and Lopen in February, because they'll be accompanying our All-State Choirs February 25th. February 5th in Cape and Lopen. So I'm going to turn it over to Dr. Sammons. Thank you all so much for coming tonight.
Hi, can you hear me?
Yes.
Oh, good evening. Hi, I'm Stephen Sammons. It's a great pleasure to be here. I think it's been 2 or 3 years since we actually planned that I was going to be here, but there was this intervening pandemic thing that got in the way. So I'm really delighted to be here now. We had a very productive and wonderful time sharing music to get today. I think these are young people that may normally see themselves on the athletic field, and they're like, you know, highly competitive. Today was highly collaborative. So it was really a wonderful time to get to work with all these wonderful, talented people. They've come a long way in just a very short time because they didn't really have a lot of time with this music until we got together at 8:30 this morning, so it's been a pretty long day. There's a couple of things to point out. They are remarkable. And what I neglected to point out to all of you today is that all of the teachers here were them. At one point, we were all standing up there in our junior high or high school choirs doing exactly this kind of thing. And it's hard to predict where that journey goes. For me, it went to a rather long career, all dedicated to choral music. So it's unpredictable. This might be in your futures. And it's a wonderful place to be because you get to make art. And that, there's nothing negative about that. A little bit about the works that were just coming your way. You might notice, and I'm not sure you have enough light to read it, but the text for the first piece, which is a piece of mine, called Let Us Carry Out That Dream, comes from a speech of Robert F. Kennedy in 1968 on April 4th, the day after Martin Luther King Jr. was shot in Memphis. And we had a chance to talk about that a little bit as we were preparing the piece today. It's a very moving speech that Kennedy gave when he was, at that time, trying to be the Democratic candidate for president. He was scheduled to give a stump speech in Indianapolis, and he had just had the word that Dr. King had been assassinated, and instead of giving a political discourse, he gave one of the great pieces of political oratory of our time. And he talked about the need for unity in our country. And that still resonates today. So this may be a conversation that you might take home with you, because that's what art does. You may continue the conversation about what this speech means and what times we live in with this idea that we are carrying on a dream. The dream that is referred to in the text is from Martin Luther King's very famous speech, I Have a Dream, where all children can run free. So Kennedy is referring to that in trying to carry out that dream. We're going to follow that with 4 pieces from Brahms' Liebeslieder waltzes. These were among the most popular pieces that he wrote during his lifetime. They are a collection of love songs, which also are timeless, and we have a chance to look at those today. So I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
for supporting the arts. I'd like to thank one of our Sanford students, senior Megan Athey. She videoed the concert tonight. I'll get the link for YouTube and I'll send it out to the teachers and you all could watch at your leisure. Thank you again so much for coming. Have a nice weekend.